All right, now that we've got our receiver bound to our internal module, we're good to go, right? Well, not exactly.
If you're using a FrSky, Futaba, Corona, or Hitec protocol receiver, and you really want to get the most out of it, you should fine-tune the Jumper T16 multi-module to it. In this video, I'm going to show you how to do just that in four simple steps. Welcome back, everyone, to TMac FPV, your home for your journey to better FPV fun, flights, and racing stuff. If you haven't done so already, make sure to check out my site at tmacfpv.com. Make the time to like the video, share your comments below in the video with your friends, and make sure to subscribe. Let's get started. According to Pascal Langer, who's a multi-protocol transmitter module guru, and I've put a link to his GitHub site below, I encourage you to check it out. Multi-modules can have variations in their oscillator crystals, and therefore we should fine-tune the multi-module in our T16s to those types of receivers I just mentioned earlier. It's a very simple process and can be done in four simple steps. So why not give it a shot?
First thing you want to do is to bind your receiver to the internal multi-module just like you would normally do. Now step two, with the receiver bound, scroll over to the RF Freak Fine Tune entry. So on our model setup, and we scroll up under the internal RF multi-module, we go down here to RF Freak Fine Tune. We're going to click on that so it flashes. And then we're going to lower that value until the transmitter loses connection with the receiver.
Telemetry lost.
Right there. I'm going to scroll back up.
Telemetry recovered.
Just to make sure that we get the right number for the telemetry lost. And the receiver I'm using
telemetry lost.
At 57. Let's just call it minus 57. So that's going to be our minimum fine-tune number, and we need to remember it, so I'm going to jot it down. Now, the receiver I'm using is the FrSky RXSR telemetry receiver. Now, the next step, step three, is to go ahead and increase this number past the point at which we regain connection with the
telemetry recovered.
Past that point, keep increasing it until we lose connection again on the high side. And that's going to be our maximum fine-tune number.
Telemetry lost.
47 is when it said telemetry lost.
Telemetry recovered.
Okay, let's try it again. Increase the number.
Telemetry lost.
We're going to say 39. And that's going to be our maximum fine-tune number. Once again, we're going to have to remember that. And because I'm terrible at that, I'm going to write it down. 39. Now step four is just add these two numbers together. Minus 57 plus 39 minus 57 plus 39 and then divide it by 2. And we get negative 9. Negative 9 is going to be our middle fine-tuned freak value, and that's the number that we're going to put into the field of our T16 for this particular type of receiver, the FrSky RXSR. So we go to negative 9.
Telemetry recovered.
And input that value. And that's it. We're done. It's as simple as that. We fine-tuned our multi-module to the RXSR FrSky receiver.
Now, is this going to significantly increase your RSSI value? Maybe, maybe not. It just depends on how far off it was to begin with. But the fact that this whole process is so simple and took only a few short minutes, why not go ahead and optimize your signal connection when you can? I'd love to hear what frequency fine-tuning values you come up with, so go ahead and share those in the comments section below. Remember to share this info with your friends, and hop on over to tmacfpv.com to check out my site. Thanks for your time. I'll see you in the next video. Clear skies, friend.